Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Della Yunita. My student ID is 22232000058. Here I want to present the result of my research paper. The title is Online and Face-to-Face Classes Comparative Analysis. So the reason I choose this topic is because I think as a teacher in the future, we need to know the comparison between online and face-to-face learning and teaching so we can find out what the strengths and weaknesses are, overcome possible obstacle, and deal with the effectiveness of the two classes. Okay, next slide. Okay, here is the table of content. There are abstract, introduction, literature review, method, result, and discussion, and conclusion. Next slide. Okay, here is the abstract. The development of technology along with the changing times, it's very influential in all aspects of life, especially in the aspect of education. Nowadays, everyone is familiar with online classes or classes that are conducted remotely. This online class is very helpful when circumstances do not allow studying as usual or face-to-face. Online classes are conducted using electronic device as well as the internet, where this online class requires technological skills from both teachers and students. Teachers and students must understand the use of technology well so that the online classes can run well. Some teachers who are not disabled feel that online classes are more complicated than face-to-face classes because they are usually carried out in the traditional way, and it is also possible to carry out face-to-face classes while still using technology in class. Both face-to-face and online classes offer benefits and drawbacks. Additionally, there are differences in the face-to-face classes or online differences in the difficulties of online versus in face-to-face learning. Which type of learning is more efficient, face-to-face classes or online ones? Therefore, the purpose of this comparative research analysis is to learn how to overcome difficulties in both online and face-to-face classes and determine which is more efficient. Next, please. Okay, here's the introduction. So the current education system has undergone quite drastic changes. This is due to the rapid development of technology. With the existence of technology, learning can be done remotely using electronic devices and the internet. In addition, face-to-face classes are also still running using technology or without technology or on a limited basis. There are advantages and disadvantages to both online and in person learning. In order to identify how we might choose a more effective class based on the current scenario, the author of the study will analyze the advantages and disadvantages of online and face-to-face classes. Some of the questions that will be answered in this comparative analysis are: the first is how to overcome the challenges of both class, and the second one is which one is more effective for English learning. Next slide. Okay, the next is the literature review. The first is there is the concept of online class. So internet-based education is referred to as online learning. E-learning is one of the names that is frequently used to describe it. Online education is simply one kind of distance through. And additionally, interactive learning telecommunication systems are needed for online learning in order to link educators and students, as well as the different resources that are required for it. Because online learning explicitly refers to education that makes use of internet-based technology, in this case, in order to be able to teach students online, educators must process technical knowledge in the field of technology. Additionally, students must be ready to learn how to use the technology used at their individual universities. And second is there is types of online class. The first, there is asynchronous online classes that don't take place in real time. Students complete their coursework and assignments more independently and on time. The teacher and students communicate using message boards, blogs, email, and other channels. The time of class meetings is flexible, and students with busy schedules or time constraints might benefit from the flexibility and usefulness of asynchronous learning. And the second one is there is synchronous online class. Synchronous online classes necessitate concurrent students and instructor online contact. In a virtual classroom, teachers train the students and facilitate communication between them using text message, audio chats, and audio and video chats. Synchronous learning environments enable students to take a course from home and participate in real-time activities. Next, there is the advantages and disadvantages of online class. The advantages of online class are their full-time savings, exposure to new learning methods, and simple access to internet materials are benefits of online learning. Online learning has some advantages. Disadvantages like spending a lot of time staring at screens, not moving around much, not interacting, and having trouble understanding what is being taught. And then the next, there is the concept of face-to-face class. The teachers transmit knowledge to students in face-to-face teacher-centered learning paradigm with little involvement from the students. According to Hardin and Crosby, 2000, during teaching and learning activities, students and teachers as well as other students can directly interact with while using the face-to-face learning paradigm. In other words, there is absolutely no access to the internet for teachers, students, or kids who are interacting with other pupils. And the last one, there is the advantages and disadvantages of face-to-face class. The advantage of face-to-face classes is that teaching and learning activities will feel more active because it is easier for teachers and students to interact directly with each other, and teachers will find it easier to access. While the disadvantages of the disadvantage of face-to-face classes are the lack of students' independence and lack of flexibility. Next slide. Okay, the next is the method. This analysis uses a qualitative method by collecting several journals about online and face-to-face English classes which contain advantages and disadvantages as well as challenges, and then compare and analyze them so as to get results on how to overcome the challenges and which ones are more effective. Next slide, please. And the next is result and discussion. The first is to overcome challenges posed by online classroom. Teachers, educators offer 17 key coping strategies, including those for online teaching, planning, managing online classrooms, promoting teachers' well-being, helping students with their mental health, and improving students' access to or use of technology. While in-person classes or face-to-face class, can be addressed by fostering effective communication and engagement and raising student motivation to learn. Next. And the second is to increase the effectiveness of online class. It is necessary to ensure that teachers and students understand the technology that will be used in learning, classroom management by teachers, and good communication. Meanwhile, face-to-face classes with clear instruction and direct interaction between teachers and students with students will both increase the effectiveness of the class. Next. Okay, so here's the conclusion. The conclusion obtained from the result of comparative analysis between online and face-to-face classes is that each has different way of dealing with the challenges. In online classes, teachers need to plan online teaching, manage online classroom, and improve students' ability to access technology. Teachers must, however, increase the pupils' motivation and self-assurance in face-to-face classes. Both online and in-person seminars offer benefits and drawbacks. The teacher's management of the class and ability to work through obstacles will determine how effectively the class is established. Next. Okay, thank you. That is for me. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, Mr. Safiza and my friends. I want to presentation. The title is Differentiated Instruction as a Teaching. Next. Level of content. The first abstract, second introduction, the third literature review, four methodology, five findings, and the last conclusion. Next. The first slide is abstract. Differential instruction is an approach to teaching that recognizes and address the various learning needs of students in a classroom. It involves tailoring learning to suit the specific requirements of every pupil, including learning habits, interests, and their level of getting ready. Students can learn in a range of ways. This method, such flexible grouping, choice boards, as well as other assessment, so as to make the curriculum accessible to all students. It also needs to be changed. Differentiated instruction may improve to the engagement, motivation, and achievement by offering a tailored learning experience for teachers to effectively implement this approach. Teachers must constantly assess their methods and implement changes to ensure that all students are sufficiently changed and supported in the learning. Keyword: personal instruction, personal learning, or different needs for learning. Next. The next slide is introduction. Next. Refers to educators' attempts to reach to difference among students in the classroom. Differentiating instruction occurs whenever a teacher reaches out to a person or select group to customize their instruction to have the best educational experience. Next. The next is literature review. Diverse needs for learning of students met by the use of different instruction, a method of instruction and learning based to all students' special abilities, patience, and learning states. Multiple routes must be provided for students to find and demonstrate their learning. The value of differentiated instruction as a teaching strategy is located in the following literature review. Next. Next, methodology. Research uses various methods, including quantitative, to investigate the effectiveness of differentiated instruction as a teaching method. Quantitative methods involve analyzing numerical data, while quantitative methods involve collecting non-numerical data. Mixed method combining both quantitative and qualitative and method. Additionally, research may use case studies or action research to explore different instruction in specific classroom or school. The choice of research method depends on the research question and goals of the study. Next. Next is findings from the first question in this category reflect that student general share the same views about the benefits of different instruction. The majority of these respondents comments on the with which learning was taking place because they were given a best they describe different instruction as a more democratic teaching approach, which gave them a chance to perform at their optimum level on one student put it this way. Different instruction was useful for me. It was effective, afforded me the opportunity to work with there than the regular ones that I work with felt confidence because I chose the mode of evaluation. Next. The last is conclusion. A way of this difference instruction method acknowledge the diversity of students and their individual learning needs. It offers various options for students to learn and understand concepts based on their interests and abilities. Teachers need to handle this diversity is appropriate to help learn meet their learning objective. While collaborative activities are essential, teachers must balance them with student comfort level, especially in public speaking, despite being time consuming and complicated. Different instruction can be valuable part of the learning process. Creating a supportive classroom and environment for students. Next. Thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan Honorable Mr. Syafrijal as the lecturer of seminar on English teaching and welcome to all my friends here. So my name is Nurul Rahmawati with students number 22232 0061. And here I would like to present my research paper with the title The Effectiveness of Using Short Story as a Narrative Text to Improve Students' Reading Comprehension Ability. And the reason I choose this topic because reading comprehension is very important because it can make reading enjoyable, fun, and informative, and it is needed to success in school, work, and general life. Next slide, please. And here are the table of contents. The first is there is abstract. The second is the introduction. The third is literature review. The fourth is method. The fifth is findings, and the sixth is conclusion. Next slide, please. The first is abstract. The purpose of this study is to analyze the effectiveness of using short story as the narrative text to improve EFL students' reading comprehension ability. This study is Classroom Action Research, or CIR. The data was conducted in Al-Ijtihad Islamic High School Tangerang, which the sample is 10 students from first grade level. And this study is used mixed method, which the data are collected using both qualitative and quantitative. The qualitative data is analyzed using notes, observation, sheet, and interviews. The quantitative data is analyzed using pretest, post-test, and assessment score. The results of the study indicate that using short stories as a form of narrative text has been successful in increasing readers' capacity for students' reading comprehension ability because the existence of increased students' reading comprehension of narrative text improve from meeting one to meeting two and meeting two to meeting three. The researchers suggest that English teachers should use short stories in teaching reading to increase students' reading comprehension ability. And the keywords for this research is narrative text, reading comprehension, and short story. Next, please. And here are the introduction. This is the background of the problem. English is used by people all over the world as a universal language for communication. As a result of its widespread use of significant impact on all aspects of our daily lives, this international language is essential for education and must be taught in both formal and informal learning environments. As a result, once they have mastered it, the student must be able to use the language in daily situation in an effective and precise manner. To put it in another way, the primary form of communication human is use is language. It is important to learn the basic of the language, such as speaking, reading, writing, listening, and speaking out loud, as well as its components such as vocabulary, pronunciation, and grammar, in order to be able to use the English language. And the reading is one of the skills required for EFL students to learn English. Reading is one of important things in English language teaching and become one of ability which should be mastered by students. Reading is a type of language skill that is frequently regarded as a crucial because it has the goal of simply conveying data and has the potential to deepen one's understanding of the world, which is frequently regarded as a crucial. Next slide, please. And the formulation of the problem is the first, how does the using of stories as a form of narrative text help students understand what they are reading, and how effective is the use of short story as a narrative text for teaching reading comprehension to students? Next slide, please. And here are the literature review. The first is the previous study. Previously, the academy has studied the effect of narrative writing on student learning, as well as other studies related to this topic. Furthermore, this research was conducted by Ramadan 2017. According to the research entitled The Influence of Vocabulary and Grammar Management on the Understanding of Reading English Narrative Text, and Utami et al. 2014, according to research entitled The Influence of Reader Response Strategies and Reading Interest Students Against Reading Comprehension of Narrative Text, class first grade of SMA 2 Bengkulu City. The result of the study showed that reader response strategy is more effective for reading learning than small group discussion, and there is no interaction between the two strategies for reading learning, reader response strategy, and small group discussion. The second is the nature of reading comprehension. The activity of understanding the text is known as reading comprehension. It is an intentional, active, and interactive process that occurs in three ways: interaction, namely before, during, and after reading certain writings. Reading. And the third is the purpose of reading. According to Sparman 2005, there are two primary reasons for reading. The first is reading for enjoyment, and the second is reading for information. Next. And next is teaching reading comprehension. Teaching is defined as the process of providing opportunities for students to learn through sharing knowledge or experience. Brown 2000 defines reading as a process in which a teacher improves and facilitates learning, provides time for students to learn, and limits students' ability to learn. Susan clarifies that learning is a collaborative effort between students and teachers. And the next is Narrative text. Narrative text is a text that tells a story that is usually imagistic or fantasy with the aim of entertaining the reader. The text of narrative text, there is fables, fairies, ballads, legends, horror stories, romance, science fiction, and mysteries. And the text structure, there is orientation, complication, resolution, and reorientation. And the linguistic features are use simple past tense and usually begin with the adverb of time. Next. And the method. This research paper use classroom action research, and this study is use mixed method, which the data is collected through qualitative and quantitative. The data was conducted in Al Ijtihad Islamic High School Tangerang, which the sample is 10 students from first grade level. The method of selecting samples used in this study is random. The qualitative data is analyzed using interviews. The quantitative data is analyzed using assessment score. And according to Creswell 2012, interviews are used to learn about a person's earnings, habits, and preference. By performing an interview, you will be able to provide some information as well as personal information. Next slide, please. And here are the findings. The first is quantitative findings. Here is the table of student score in doing assessment related to reading comprehension using a short story. In the first meeting, the finding the main idea is 45.3, and identifying detail 47.6, and for recognizing vocabulary, there is 45.1, and summarizing concept 39.3. And there is improvement in meeting two. The score in finding the main idea is 52.6. For identifying detail 49.7, and recognizing vocabulary 47.5, and summarizing concept 46.8. And there's the improvement in meeting three. In defining idea, there is 46.8, identifying detail 45.7, recognizing vocabulary 47.9, and summarizing concept 49.8. And the average score for finding the main idea is 51.6. For identifying detail is 68.8. For recognizing vocabulary is 46.8. And summarizing concept is 48.6. Next slide, please. And here is the qualitative findings. There is in-depth interview. There is the researchers asking about students' opinions about studying reading comprehension by using short story. And it was found that 7 students, which is 70%, said that short story or text that is written in English helped them in learning reading comprehension. And 3 students said that the short story didn't give any contribution in learning reading comprehension due to the lack of vocabulary. Next slide, please. And the conclusion, the result of the study can be summarized as follows. Short stories give students more opportunities to study in school by allowing them to write on the reading test. They can improve their reading comprehension by participating in the above mentioned activities. Teachers can use short stories to teach EFL students reading comprehension because it increases the student learning capacity. Next slide. And here are the references. Next slide. And here is the Turnitin result. There is 16% similarity index. Next. And that's all from my presentation. Thank you, and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Anggun Nurani, and my student number is 22232001 04. And here I would like to explain my paper with the title Classroom Management Strategies of Teaching English in Large Classes. And the table of contents are first abstract, second introduction, third literature review, fourth research methodology, five result and discussion, and the last conclusion and suggestion. First abstract. The goal of this study is to outline the ideal approach for controlling big class size. Classroom management tactics are essential for a successful learning process because the word classroom management is quite wide and there are numerous ways to categorize different classroom viewpoints and learning style. According to Ari Kunto in Jamara 2006, point 177, classroom leadership is an effort made by the person in charge of the teaching and learning activities or someone who works to create the best possible environment for learning activities. The method employed in this study is a descriptive qualitative approach and the tool is observation. According to the study's finding, English teachers use a variety of techniques used to control large classes, including changing how students are seated, interacting between teachers and students, grouping students, be disciplined, be fair with the student, and using media to explain material. The second is introduction. Background of the study, the best way to make people's life better is through education, through their involvement in achieving educational goals. All levels of society must be empowered through education. Furthermore, Suhartono 2015 argues that the purpose of ethic education is to help children form appropriate behavioral values to help them develop, become intelligent, emotionally intelligent, and develop spiritually. Teachers who can effectively manage the class are considered to be professionals. Every lesson in class involves encounters and progressing. Therefore, competent management of the class is appropriate. The ability to regulate classroom learning so that it is always maintained is necessary for the development of an effective classroom teacher. The phrase classroom management refers to the concept of management. And the research question, one, what are the teacher challenges in implementing classroom management strategies? And two, how does classroom management impact students? And the objective of the study, first, to analyze the teacher challenges in implementing classroom management strategies in large classes, and to determine the impact of classroom management on students. And the third, literature review. The previous study, the term learning strategies is used in a fairly broad sense by one of the first research in this field, Rubin, 1975.43, who defines it as techniques or tools that learners can use to acquire knowledge. The term classroom management refers to the vast range of abilities and strategies teachers employ to keep their students on track, focus, orderly, structure, and academically productive throughout a lesson. When classroom management techniques are used effectively, teachers reduce the behaviors that hinder learning for both individual students and groups of students while enhancing the behaviors that support or enhance learning. Classroom management is defined as classroom management, namely the leadership or management of teachers in the administration of their class, by N.A. Emmett-Tambone, 1980.30. The teacher's goal in managing the learning environment is to establish and coordinate the condition for student learning so that they are motivated to participate in class with a sense of responsibility and are content with accomplishing the set learning objective. According to Arikunto Injamara, 2006.177, classroom leadership is an effort made by the person in charge of teaching and learning activities or someone who works to create the best possible environment for learning activities. The next is research methodology. The research design, a qualitative approach was used based on the research objective. The method is also known as naturalistic inquiry since it focuses on things that occur in the natural world, according by Sugiono, 2006.14. The technique of collecting data in this research is to find the data through observation. The next is research and discussion. Finding research, an efficient classroom is one in which both teachers and students may be at their best. With a classroom management strategy, students will become more productive, organized, and focused through better classroom management. The establishment and maintenance of an orderly atmosphere for students, the provision of change for substantive academic learning, and the promotion of social and emotional development, the education of disruptive conduct, and the extension of instructional time are all good impact. Next. And then the study's findings suggest that the teachers in managing large classes are changing how students are seated. This is done to combat the bored that some students experience when learning in class, particularly when learning English. The second is interacting between teachers and students. The teacher regularly asks the class to repeat what they have just said, engages them in question and answer session, assigning students to read the assigned readings, and engages them in conversation with the teacher or other students. The next is grouping students. These strategies can be implemented by the teacher. Group the students to improve their vocabulary. And the next, discipline. Teachers can also set boundaries with reference to school rules. Small things like entering class before it rings will make student discipline. Next is be fair with the student. The teachers then make sure that to give students your full attention and to treat them with respect. Because the teacher treated every student equally, they would adore and respect her. And the last is using media to explain material. The teachers can use PowerPoint or web-based learning to make students interested and keep them engaged on their studies. And these challenges include the following. The first, the classroom environment, regardless of the school setting, inadequate classroom conditions are among the issues teachers challenges face when managing their classes. The second is misbehavior on the part of students. Students' problems that often occur, such as talking while learning is in progress, being late, and failing to complete assignment. And the last, students' attitude and linguistic proficiency. The linguistic proficiency and classroom attitudes of the kids were some other problems. Next. The last is conclusion and suggestion. The conclusion is teachers can use a variety of classroom management strategies in large classes, including changing how students are seated, interacting between teachers and students, grouping students, be disciplined, be fair with the students, and using media to explain material. The classroom strategies is run can have a positive effect on the students since it teaches them how to be disciplined, develop their critical thinking abilities, give them the confidence to speak up, helps them learn how to get along with others, ensure that the pupils comprehend the information, and then pique their interest in the learning process. And a suggestion, in order to establish a favorable learning environment, teachers must also know how to develop their habits and skill in teaching English. Teachers must use cutting edge techniques in the classroom if they want to boost students' engagement in the learning process. By engaging in practice and experience, students must take their English seriously. Then, when learning English, students try to be more enthusiastic and creative. Thank you. I think enough. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let me introduce myself. My name is Amira Nuraini. Here I would like to present the paper with the title Student Perception of New Technology Duolingo for learning English vocabulary. Here are table of contents. The first abstract. The second is introduction. The third literature review. The fourth methodology. The fifth result. And the last conclusion. The first is abstract. This study goal is to examine how students feel about using Duolingo to learn English vocabulary. The qualitative method was used to design the study. In the study, data was gathered from literature research, and the data in the study were analyzed using some related articles. The next introduction, in an effort to provide quality while also facilitating learning, media is used in education. Using the software is an essential component of student acceptable interactive learning. Duolingo is an excellent tool for learning a second language. Here the research question. What are students talk on using Duolingo to learn English? This vocabulary, according to Sartre 2014, defined vocabulary as knowledge about words and their meanings. Vocabulary is the fundamental skill that students must master before moving on to reading, writing, listening, and speaking. While Duolingo is a website and app for free language learning, Duolingo, according to White 2014, because they translate is an online education platform that enables users to take unrestricted language course tested by their website. Duolingo creates a world with free education and no language barriers. The methodology, this study used a qualitative approach which described the opinions of the student using Duolingo to learn English vocabulary. The data collection technique used in the study is literature research, and the research descriptive in nature. The result, Duolingo is a well-liked learning tool and the future language learning. Claims will 2016. Duolingo is an option to answer visual, audio, and grammar questions. The method used to deliver learning material is enjoyable, according to Putri and Islamiyati 2018. Because the Duolingo application system has a variety of features, including games that give users the impression that they are learning as they play, and visually appealing audio accompanied display. The objective of Duolingo, the first to provide user with free language instruction in other language to improve one ability, words and sentences from the user language are translated into English, and the last capable of writing the appropriate word on the appropriate image. And here, student perception of using Duolingo. The first Duolingo application was simple to use. According to the review literature, some students state that Duolingo application is easy to use. It can be installed on any smartphone that is compatible, allowing the student to study anywhere. The next teacher and student got benefit from collaborative learning activities. So teacher and student got benefit from collaborative activities aided by technology. Using Duolingo is one of methods that can help teaching and learning. And the last, Duolingo application is helpful. So the conclusion is, the Duolingo application will make language learning more exciting and enjoyable. As a result, it can aid students in expanding their vocabulary in English. The article concludes that students opinions of using Duolingo to learn English, particularly vocabulary, are positive. It has numerous advantages for assisting student learning process because it can make student English skill better, simpler to use, fun, and encouraging. So here are the reference. Thank you. I think it's enough from me. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.